Hello friends, this is the Sena 20S EVO, the latest release from Sena 20S. Oh, I just received this box yesterday and I'm just going to unbox it right now. So these are the descriptions that we see. The Sena 20S, whatever the components which are there inside. So I'm just excited to use this for my next ride. So let's go ahead and see what is inside. Okay. There's another box inside that. Here it comes. Nice foam which has padded all the instruments, and I'm seeing everything here. The Bluetooth device, the holder with the boom microphone, the speakers here. So this is the latest updated one from the 20S family. Earlier I think you had the antenna which flips up. Here there's a direct shark fin antenna, so you don't need to flip it up right now. So these are the contents. This is the Bluetooth device. The holder which comes with the speakers and the boom microphone. I have both the speakers here. One is a longer wire speaker and the other one is a shorter wire. And this is the boom microphone. I have some additional things inside the kit here. There is a car charger, a USB cable, a user manual. I prefer there'll be constant updates, so you have to keep checking the website or the internet to download the latest updated format of the user manual. Along with that, I have some additional kit here. These are some of the noise reduction pads for the speakers, the boom microphones, and the additional paddings for the speakers. And you can even stick, they're given 3M tapes to stick the speakers onto your helmets. And some additional padding. They're given 3M stickers for the clamp also. But friends, this is the helmet that I'm going to install my 20S EVO. On the right side I have the holder for the drift action camera, so I'm planning to fix it here on the left side somewhere here. Let me see where exactly I can mount it. So I have this device. I'm going to unscrew this and I'm going to fit it on the side of the helmet. I do have this pin where I can unscrew it. Got the screws in place now. Just tightening up the screws. Just trying to get it as tight as possible. Yeah. Yes, pretty firm. Going to use any additional velcro padding because I think I have sufficient padding here. So let me just try with this. If not, I can even redo it again. speakers have sat in beautifully here. It's here. Hope you can see it. It's stuck on and it will not move now. Taking the other speaker. Just sticking it along the way so that I don't have to worry whether it's moving or whether it's the right position every now and then. I just stick it and I can comfortably put the paddings back on. These tapes are really handy. You can just fix the tapes so that these wires don't cross over on those areas that you really might worry about, those buttons and that. So you can just stick them comfortably there. Just trying to make sure that some part of the wire goes right on top. Well, I heard that the antenna comes right on top, so if you want to use radio stations, it's better if the wires come on top. Okay, fair enough. I'm going to put the paddings back on, the head padding back on. Just got the top padding on. Before I put the side pads, I'll have to make sure I get my other drift camera wire also inside. So the camera is going to be here at this distance. This gap needs to be there. So the rest of it I'm going to fold. Alright, now I'm going to slide in my cheek cushions. These buttons are nice and strong and sturdy. It's quite easy to use, to remove, and quite comfortable. The helmet is back in shape right now. So this is how it's going to be. This wire here is going to be connected to my drift camera right from behind. I can even pull it if I want a little bit. It's adjustable, I've kept it like that. And when I'm not using it, I can just tuck it up aside here. So it's all tucked up. And these two wires are going to be slightly outside like this. But when you wear it, this part is not going to interfere because it's going to hit on the back of my head. So I don't think this will be much of an interference right now. And I can see the speakers from here. It's in a more comfortable position, so I hope this is not, I don't need those extra padding. Absolutely fine. I don't feel that I have so many gadgets attached to my helmet at all. This area is not disturbing me, right? Reasonable place where I can handle the Sena. And my camera is going to be here. The wire is tucked inside so that I can put it in. So everything seems comfortable. Let me try it during my ride and I'll give you my reviews after that. This is my fully equipped MT Revenge Binomi helmet. I have the Drift Ghost Ace action camera, which is wired to the wired microphone, external microphone that is inside the helmet. And this side I have the Sena Bluetooth device. So I'm going to use it for a ride today and just planning for a short around 250 km trip. I'll be back in the evening. And I'll be eager to post the videos on YouTube for you guys. See you.